Because I think there are 11 stories in this book, out of which 6 are from a feminist point of view. You know, so, and she is like, I must you know, say this, that she has been given the epithet of Gurjan, a writer who rules, because she has taken up cudgels not only for the villagers that she lives with, but the women in those villages. And maybe it also is about the way she was brought up and the experiences that she went through. And she identifies that with the rest of the women. And each one of the stories, like I'm telling you, are the 11, 6 of them are from a woman's point of view. And it's not just like, you know, about patriarchy, which of course, you know, is a thread which is common to most of the stories. But it's also about, you know, sexuality of women, of you know, what we call the queer literature. Okay, she also goes into that and how she stands up for that character, and you know, projects that character in a very sympathetic, with empathy, but also with boldness. That this is how it should be, and this is how, you know, that woman should stand up for herself.
But she was my colleague when I was doing my PG diploma in folklore. We had a very good relationship. So she had actually made such a picture that she's very bold. And
that's how she projected herself all the time.
But in reality, she was not like that.
She was not like that.
And I was all the time in that mindset of that. My friend, she is very bold, and she will now. She has completed this diploma with me, and she has done her PG post graduation, and she's teaching. She's career stick my dad. She's professor in some district. And after coming from that place, actually, it's a real. As I told you, when I came in Goa, and all the time I was in that feeling. Suddenly I had an occasion after 2-3 years to visit her place, that Sati and everything. Actually, that festival is not real. That is my imaginary part, because I'm visiting her place again, her own house now, which she's married, for that Sati festival. And because here I'm also very busy as a cultural organizer and everything. So I have no time, because I have that, I wanted to record, document that festival, so I am visiting that place. And I had something, some imagination, my mind, my friend, she is professor, and she is, and before coming, she told me about that her husband, now who is her husband, no, that story, that her brother, elder brother, insisting her, get married with her brother-in-law. So she told me that time he has forced his wife to suicide. And the way she was talking, you know, say feminist thing and everything was there. And when I
actually met her,
I was really shocked. I cannot say that she is also a common housewife. Worst was her condition. And, you know,
such a paradox completely of what she projected and what turned out.
And many times I think
it's
not like family. Many times family makes you to live like that. many times we surrender.
Yeah.
We ladies or girls, we surrender. Because she could have rejected all that. No, she could have.
Yes, she could have taken a stand.
Yeah, stand. That she is not married with that widow and all that. And even that worst part is that she had given birth to one more baby. And she's telling me she's teaching and everything.
Do you think some people lead those kind of double lives, like their imagination?
I was so shocked, you know. Yes, Bai told that he has written a real story. Here also, except the name, the story is really, means I have written the real facts. Only, the writer, creative writers.
Completely a psychological story of the two worlds that the protagonist inhabits. Alright. And so in the end,
that character from my story. I see many times even hearing our own Kokri writers that field also. I met some characters like that. So they also sometimes pretend. They are very happy, husband is supporting and children are supporting for writing. But real fact is different.